Hello everybody, welcome to this course on services marketing with a practical approach. My name is Dr. Biplab Datta and my contact details are given here. So once you watch this video, if you have any queries or any feedback, you can always write to me and I will see that your feedback is taken care of, and I'll also try as much as possible to reply to you. So today we are going to look at the fifth lesson in this course, which is understanding the macro environment part 1. In that we have two concepts, one is analyzing the macro environment and the political environment. So this is a picture of the business environment. We can see our company here in the center, and then we have the micro environment within which the company operates, that is consisting of suppliers, customers, public, intermediaries, competitors, shareholders, etc. And then this micro environment is within a macro environment, and that macro environment consists of political environment, the economic environment, social environment and the technological environment. So no company operates in a vacuum, it operates in some kind of environment, and that is what we are going to see in this lesson as well as the next lesson, how the company's environment affects the delivery of services by the company. So we come to analyzing the macro environment. So the macro environment is an independent variable that affects any company and determines whether the company would be able to produce and deliver its services in harmony with the prevailing business environment. So the macro environment determines whether the company would be able to produce and deliver its services in harmony with the prevailing business environment, means whether the company has a good fit with the business environment. Now we have to analyze the business environment, and the way to analyze this macro environment is the political, economic, social and technological dimensions. This environment is therefore analyzed using the PEST analysis. PEST stand for political, economic, social and technological. So we come to the political environment. We must analyze the political environment to make sure that our company is operating within legal boundaries and are congruent with common business practice. We must be aware of the impact of changing political powers on our business. We must also understand how political practices can enable or hinder the growth of our business. For example, mandatory recycling laws have boosted the recycling industry. For instance, food service companies like Nestle and Starbucks recycle their paper cups. So this is how the political environment is affecting the business environment. Now the political environment of a business can be analyzed from two perspectives. The first perspective is the business legislation, and the second perspective is the activity of special interest groups. So we come to business legislation. The aim of business legislation is to protect companies from unfair competition, to protect consumers from unfair business practices, to protect the interest of society from unbridled business behavior, and to charge businesses with the social costs created by their products or the production process. So here the aim, in a nutshell, the aim of the business legislation is to protect companies from unfair competition, protect consumers from unfair practices, protect the interest of the society from unbridled business behavior, and charge businesses with the social costs created by their products or production processes. So although each new law has a legitimate rationale, it can have unintended effect on sapping initiative and restricting business growth. So in India, the Competition Commission has been set up under the Competition Act 2002 to promote and sustain competition and protect the interest of consumers through legislation. So, coming to business legislation can be further analyzed in terms of 5 factors, namely laws and regulations, legislation, administration, adjudication and lobbying. So, we will see these factors one by one. Laws and regulations. Laws and regulations refer to bills that have been passed or are in effect. Examples of laws and regulations that can affect our business are price controls on room tariffs and other charges in a hotel. So, these controls are made by the regulators of different businesses. Then taxes, then licensing of barber shops, pools, restaurants, nightclubs, bars, etc. Putting tax holidays, safety standards in the particular industry, building bylaws, minimum labor wages and available police force. So, these are all part of the laws and regulations which refer to bills that have been passed or are in effect. So, the laws and regulations, a list of important laws relating to conducting business in India are given below. So, business legislation in India, we have several acts. So, the first act is the Prevention of Food Adulteration Act 1954, Drugs Control Act 1954, Company Act 1956, Standard Weights and Measures Act 1976, Display of Price Order 1963, Indian Patents Act 1970, Packaged Commodities Regulation Order 1975, Consumer Protection Act 1986, Water Prevention and Control of Pollution Act 1974, Air Prevention and Control of Pollution Act 1981, Environment Protection Act 1986 and Competition Act 2002. So, under the Competition Act, a Competition Commission has also been established, and this to ensure that unfair competition or some kind of cartels or monopolies are not formed by the several businesses operating in the country. Then we come to legislation. Legislation refers to the process by which bills are passed, rejected or shelved. Examples of legislation that can affect our business are raising and passage of bill introducing value added and service tax. So, recently the general service tax was also passed, you might be knowing that. Raising and passage of bill introducing quotas in hiring of employees. Raising and passage of bill closing nightclubs in hotels or that banning gambling. So, these are some of the legislation which have been passed and which have been raised, and this legislation on affects the business. So, we must be aware of what legislation is being processed or being passed and how that will affect our business. Then comes administration. So, administration refers to how laws and regulations are managed and enforced by governments. Examples of administration that can affect our business are government's grading system of a hotel, waiver on import duties on materials required for construction or refurbishment of a service facility, restriction on business hours of a service, controls on purchasing systems, national airline policies that dictate the entry or exit of tourists from a country, and integrity and corruption in the business environment. So, these are some of the examples of administration that can affect our business. This is about the administration of laws and regulations in the political environment. Then comes adjudication. So, adjudication refers to where and how laws and regulations are enforced. Examples of adjudication that can affect our business are court decisions on enforcement of service contracts, decisions of consumer courts, court decisions on legal implications of overbooking and infringement of consumer rights, overall integrity of the judicial system and quality of the judiciary, and enforceability of foreign judgments or arbitration awards. So, these are basically to do with several court decisions in different aspects, and these decisions also have to be known by the businesses so that they may follow these decisions and they do not repeat history, as they say it. Then the question of lobbying. Now, lobbying refers to the activity of interest groups to influence lawmakers and administrative officials to meet their interests. Examples of lobbying that can affect our business are access to government officials either directly or through an association. So, people can form a lobby and access government officials directly or through an association and would try to influence them. Then, use of service association as a lobbying group. Existing laws related to lobbying that must be known so that while lobbying, the companies do not violate any of these laws. Ability to hire executives who are knowledgeable of the working of government officials and the ability to manage government involvement on the working of a service organization. Then we come to the activity of special interest groups. An important force affecting businesses worldwide and particularly in India is the consumerist movement. The Government of India passed the Consumer Protection Act 1986, under which 6 rights of consumers have been recognized. These include safety, information, choice, representation, redress, and consumer education. So, as far as safety is concerned, it is the right to be protected against the marketing of goods and services that are hazardous to life and property. Information, to protect consumers against unfair trade practices, and the right to be informed about the quality, quantity, purity, standard, and price. Choice, the right to choose a variety of products and services at competitive prices. Representation, the right to be heard and be assured that the consumer's interests will receive due consideration at appropriate forum. Redress, the right to seek redress against unfair and restrictive trade practices and unscrupulous exploitation of consumers. Consumer education, the right to be educated about products and services. So, these activities of special interest groups, they have to abide by the Consumer Protection Act 1986, which under which there are 6 rights that consumers have while purchasing or using any of the services of a particular company. Thank you. I hope this video helps you.